Aloha. Last night was a true testament to the record-breaking voter turnout that we have seen across our state and the country for this momentous election. It is without question that the will of the voters to be heard is far greater than we have ever seen in our state's and our country's history. As someone who began this campaign 22 months ago, in hopes to ensure that the people of Hawaii are truly heard and represented, I could not be more pleased. That is why I would like to personally mahalo everyone who stood in long lines, who voted and made their voices heard. Exercising this fundamental right and privilege is crucial to our democracy. It is also extremely encouraging to see younger voters and first-time voters participate in this historic election. I am deeply honored and humbled to be elected by the people of Hawaii to serve the 2nd Congressional District in the United States House of Representatives. Since our campaign began, I have had the privilege of hearing from and speaking with so many people from all walks of life across our state. I've heard your struggles, and I've seen your determination in the face of adversity. I've witnessed everyday heroes throughout our community, and you inspire me to do all I can to serve the people of Hawaii. I promise to work hard, to represent you in Washington, D.C., and honor the trust and confidence that you have placed in me to represent you. This is a critical time for our country. We have been divided for far too long. Race, socioeconomic class, and partisan politics have torn away at the fabric of our nation. As Americans, we need to unite to heal these differences if we are to overcome the unprecedented challenges our country faces. We must be patient. I'm committed to working with our congressional delegates and leaders in Washington, D.C., on both sides of the aisle to tackle the tough issues and do what is right for Hawaii and our country. I want to bring the spirit of unity and the values of aloha to Washington, D.C. This campaign has been an amazing journey that I will always remember, and I could not have done this without the love, support, and sacrifice of my wife, Maria, and our daughters, Alea, Iolana, and Namaka, and I am forever grateful to them. I'm also grateful for the example of my father, the late State Senator Gil Kahele, who urged me before he passed away in January of 2016 to carry on his work in public service. His lifelong commitment to serve our community and those most vulnerable will always be my inspiration. That is why I have his photo displayed here in our campaign headquarters in Hilo. And I know that if he was here right now, that he would be smiling and enjoying the camaraderie of our campaign team and the excitement of this incredible opportunity. I said it last night, and I'm going to say it again. I want to thank and send a sincere mahalo nui loa to our Team Kahele statewide campaign team and all of our supporters and volunteers across the Hawaiian Islands for working tirelessly on this campaign, including while I was serving on active duty from April to August with the Hawaii National Guard in its COVID-19 response efforts. From Kauai to Hawaii Island, from Hilo to Hanalei, Our supporters and volunteers have worked tirelessly for the last 22 months on this campaign, and I am so deeply appreciative for their hard work. I also want to thank our campaign's honorary co-chairs and former Hawaii governors, Governor John Waihe'e, Governor Ben Cayetano, and Governor Neil Abercrombie, for their support from day one. In addition, I would like to thank all of the leaders and organizations who endorsed our campaign, including former President Barack Obama, former Vice President Joe Biden, Senators Brian Schatz, Mazie Hirono, and Congressman and my colleague, Ed Case. All of the Hawaii public unions and organizations representing our hardworking men and women throughout Hawaii, as well as the many organizations across our state and country who believe in what we stand for. I also want to thank the numerous individuals and organizations who generously donated to our campaign, which helped us share our vision for building a better and brighter future for Hawaii and our nation. Finally, I want to thank Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard for her 8 years of service representing Hawaii's 2nd Congressional District, as well as her hardworking staff, both here in Hawaii and Washington, D.C. I wish her well in her future endeavors. Today begins my transition to represent Hawaii in Congress. The 117th Congress will convene in exactly 60 days, and there is an incredible amount of work to do. First and foremost is putting together my team in Washington, D.C. and Hawaii. And as a result, I am immediately looking for the best and the brightest Hawaii and our country has to offer to join me on my journey to Washington, D.C. I urge everyone who is interested in working on our congressional staff to visit my website, kaikahele.com, and apply today for the many positions available here in Hawaii and Washington, D.C. This is a pivotal time. The COVID-19 pandemic continues to disrupt every aspect of our lives. Health, safety, jobs, education, the economy, and the future of Hawaii are at risk. Hawaii's families and businesses all across our state are struggling to survive. From day one, I will work with our congressional delegates to bring Hawaii the necessary federal resources it needs to recover. It will take everyone, state, federal, local, county governments, the private sector, nonprofit organizations, community organizations, and people like you to work together to move Hawaii and our nation forward. Though the challenges are great, we will get through this by working together. I truly believe, a'ohe hana nui ke alui'a, no work is too big when shared by all. Me kaha'aha'a with all my humility. Mahalo for your support, and imua Hawaii.